So now let's design a more complicated vending machine. So doing this by hand will be hard, but we will just draw the state diagram, okay, so that you just get the idea what is going on. So let's say we design a vending machine again, which will deliver a package of gum for 15 cents, okay, and it only accepts 5 cents nickels and 10 cents, which is dimes. And we will assume you cannot deposit nickels and dimes at the same time. So you need to deposit money one at a time, because there are many conditions that you need to be careful. As the machine gets complicated, we need to be more careful. So in this case, we have this one input for the money. We have a sensor that detects which money is deposited, whether it's a nickel or dime. Okay, this is the money input. So, and then we have this G output. It becomes one if the 15 cents is deposited, and we have this change output. Okay, so let's say this is my G for the output gum, and C for the, this is my change output. Okay, so in this case I might have, for example, 20 cents, and there will be a change in that case. If we can determine the states for this, so I will have this S0, I will call this 0 cent state, S1 5 cent state, S2 I could have 10 cent state, S3 I could have 15 cent state, and S4 I could have 20 cent state, right? If I put two dimes sequentially, consecutively, then I will get this 20 cents, right? But we cannot have any states other than this 20 cents, right? Once it becomes 15 or 20 cents, the next clock cycle, it will go back to zero state. So you cannot have a state for 25 cents, for example. So, and my output G will be 0 here, 0 here, 0 here, and it will be 1 and 1 here. And my change, it will be 0 here, 0 here, 0 here, 0 here, and it will be 1 here. So if C is 1, I will give back, return 5 cents, right? Of course, we can make this vending machine more functional. For example, we can put a return back money button. So when this button is pressed, the money inside the machine is returned. For example, assume we put 10 cents into the machine, then we decide not to buy anything. In this case, we press this button and we got our money back. But that will make it more complicated, right? So this is also possible, but we are doing it as simple as possible so that we can just follow what's going on. So now we have 5 states, so I need 3 flip-flops, right? So if I need to do my state table, I need to have these dimes first, and then nickels, and then I need to have this Q2T, Q1T, Q0T. So this will be all my inputs. So I will have these 32 cases here, right? And then I need to determine my Q2T plus 1, Q1T plus 1, Q0T plus 1. So then I have to determine my G and my C. So doing this by hand will not be very easy, because we have 32 cases, and simplifying this using Carnot maps will be difficult. Let's briefly write our state table. Here there will be this 00 state, and then we will not be changing. We have these states S0, S1, S2, S3, S4. Since we don't have 101, 110, and 111, so I need to have don't cares here, because I don't expect my machine to go into these states, and I have to include these don't cares here, right? So also, I need to do all these cases 01, 10, and 11, right? So this 11 state is also a don't care for me, so I have to include these don't cares in my Carnot map, right? So doing this by hand will be very cumbersome. So if you are doing an FPGA design, you can just model this in Verilog, and the tool will simplify it for you. But let's design this state diagram for us. So we can do it Moore or Mealy. Let's do it with a Moore in this case. So if I am in S0, if n is 0 and d is 0, then I'll go back to my state. If I am in S0, if there is a nickel, then I go to here. So this is n is 1. So if I am in S0, if there is a dime, I need to go to 10 cents. So this is d is 1. Right, so this is the 4 possibilities for S0. Of course, my reset will come here. So if I am in S1, I will be staying in S1 if n is 0 and my dime is 0, right? So if there is a nickel, then I will go to 10 cent state. So if I am in S1 state, if there is a dime, then I go to S3, to 15 cent state, right? If I am in S2, I will be staying in S2 if n is 0 and d is 0. If I am in S2, if there's a nickel, I go to here. So this is n is 1. So if there's a dime, I need to go to 20 cent state. So if I am in S3, the next clock cycle, I will be going to S0. So there is no condition for this. So you cannot stay in S3. Similarly, in S4, you will be going to do S0. So now let's write output. So in this case, G is 0, C is 0. Right, so G is 0, C is 0, G is 0, C is 0. So here in the S3 state, our G is 1, C is 0. But in the S4 state, G is 1 and C is 1.